Hello everyone, I am Fatimatu Johaporna. Welcome to my channel. Today's topic is how to upload and save image without FarmTech or SubmitButton. So let's dig in.
Here I have already a Laravel install project. Let's go to the coding. Here you can see I already defined the root, that is root gate, employ imp controller add view image. The controller, where is the function already defined, and this one is going to the welcome.blade.php. So let's go to go to the browser. I already defined here the link project URL. So refresh, control shift image. Let's go to the w3schools.com. Click here. Click here. Get these three links, Bootstrap files as well as jQuery file. Copy, go to the code, paste here. We'll take these two.js file, cut, and paste here. Well, we will create a folder under the main project. New folder called emp underscore profile. So here is the file. This is totally empty. Well, I already download some dummy picture, so just copy this one. You can download from the Google. So let's go to the main project. Where is my main project? So let's go to this link and just paste here and give this user. Well, go to the coding and in the source we'll write, so save and refresh here the image and the file application. You click here, nothing will be uploaded here. So let's do the next part. ID here. Suppose image file up ID. So copy this ID. Go down. So already write this part. When this ID, actually this file will be changed, this ID will be changed, then here this function will be executed. So let's do something also here inside. And refresh. Well, let's see. Right click. That's in aspect. look also. Yes, there is here inside. Is a chance anything here? Let's see here inside. Well, the function is working. Now we will do the image preview part here. For read the file, we will use here the file reader. Actually, when the file will be chosen or selected, so for that one, we will create a new file reader. So right here, file reader, well, new file reader. Well, this object, this reader, actually the user defined. This object lets web application read the contents of files. So do the use this. So onload equal to function. This onload, actually when the file is already loaded, there is no error, reading actually finished complete. If the reading is complete, then we will change the view from this, actually sorry, this file image source. That's mean when we change here the file, this will be changed. Actually this source will be changed. So let's change that one. When the file will be loaded, then we'll change the image. So let's use the ID here, image ID. Here, this attribute, this source attribute, src source, will be this file reader have a key keyword that is result. So maybe dot target dot result. This result, actually the keyword of file reader. This keyword actually refers the actual file reader itself. The file reader has a property called result, which is going to contain the data URL. So this will change, this will be the file, and as well as set the height, it would be 150. Yeah, copy this. This will be height, not well, save. And refresh. If we change this one, no message changing because we doesn't convert the image blob to base64 or data URL. So we have to convert this. So reader dot, and there will be the blob one. So we have to get this file which we will be selected. So to get this file, since we already write the ID here, so this will be this actually refers to this ID or this current. Then files, to get the file list, so we'll write files. These IDs files we need, so files, and for a single file we'll use zero index. And this is the image file, and this is a blog, so always read as data URL. Parameter is blob type, and this file is blob type. So here we define a new reader, file reader object. Then when the file will be uploaded, we will preview this one, but this will not showing because we need to convert it as a base 64 from the blob. So that's why we read convert this one here. So refresh right now. So refresh this one. The query is right. So just save all and refresh the page. And right now, well, the file is reviewed successfully. So let's do the image validation, like just JPEG file will be allotted, otherwise not. So copy this one, file data equal this one. There is the file. Well, then her image type equal to, and there is a file dot type. This actually this dot will give you the type of the image we will be selected. Then define a array jpg. So this is the array which will be allotted for the image type. So if not equal to not, close bracket, or if this file type actually does the uploader or chosen file type equal this match 0, this will be defined this 0 index, and then will be the 1 index. So same here, let's copy. If this or this not well, that will be 1. If this one doesn't match with the selected file type, or this one not selected with the file type, then it will give the error. So there will be the error, and otherwise you can preview and save. So preview code, this is the preview end. So just copy this one, cut and just paste here. So and showing the error, let's define a just copy this one. For here we will showing the error. If we get the error for the type, just right here move it, refresh. Well, here is the .png. There is a .png, so it should, well, it giving the error. Good. If we choose the right, I'll select this one. It is peering, but it's giving the error. So for that, I'm removing the valid type. So we'll just empty the error if there is error message. Just here empty and save. The validation is done, the review is done. Now we'll do the upload part. So let's do it here. Let's write a post data equal new from data. This new form data actually provides the way to easily construct a set of key or value pairs representing form fields and their values. This can be easily sent using Ajax to controller. So let's actually now we will create a key value pair so that we can send it to the controller. So most then write append. It just append this part with this object. So our key name will be file. Well, then here is our file. All you do will write there. We have copy just paste. Well, just write the URL. That's perfect. Well, we have to send the token headers. Then we'll create a one two. This one process data, it will be console dot success. That is meta. Or token is not mismatch. Our token mismatch error will define here. If you don't have, make sure that you add this one. Well, when the file will be uploaded, there is no type errors. So this will be come this block and it will preview, and then it will come this area, and what it will happen, it will go to this URL. That means that with this data. After successfully done in the controller, it will come here in the success function. So just define here, just copy this one and paste, and since the type is post, so it will be also post method. Since we are saving and this, and the URL will be this one, so just copy and we are paste, and this will be actually the post. Copy this one, go to this controller and just write come here, and there is a dot file. So when this file will be selected and it will come through here, what will happen? Well, I already prepared today for the time short. This file will be put this variable. This actually this file name, so this name obviously will be this one. If you write here abc, then this will be abc. So here is our file. Then for getting the extension of this variable, we just use this method get client original extension. It will give the type of image like .jpg or .png or .jpeg. So the extension will be stored here. Then for giving a rename image name, we just here use this string name user Mina, and then profile pic and dot extension. So it will be like user Mina underscore profile pic dot the dot jpg or dot jpeg. So there is the full file name, and this is the path where we will be move this file. Already I create this in the main project, that is emp profile. So this is the main project slash emp profile, and this one is the whole file part with the file name, along with the file name, that is actually this one. So it will actually we use this one later. And after getting the extension file name, this line is actually the move part. This actually will be the uploaded in the file main file project. So this data, this file, then move, this file will be moved where this path, actually this location, it will be moved. And how it will be saved, this name, as this name, it will be saved there. And after doing this task, it will be go to the success method, adding the data and the success. This is for just for the view part. So just let's go and refresh this one. Just copy and upload this one, and let's see. We get here something. No, we're not getting this one. Just save again. There was something error, probably. Again, control shifter. Choose the file. Success. Yes, actually, I forget to save the file. Here is our file is uploaded in the under the file main project. There is the file is already uploaded along with this name. So the next step is that if previous file is exist, then we will delete this one. So I already before upload the file, I already write here some few code. If this username, this actually the path along with the file name, if this is exist, so we'll remove this file, otherwise we'll do nothing. So and along with that, I already created a file table in a database. The database name empdb, and the file the table name is emp history, and the column name is id emp id underscore id emp underscore image. These both are var character, and this one is the integer and primary key. I already set up the database here. That is, here is the database name, and this is the username and the password. So I already add two lines, this one and this one. If the file is exist, so we'll just upload the file. This is the table, this table, and if the inquiry is 199, then it will be uploaded. This file will be updated. And if previous there is no picture, then we just do the insert. Actually, this is the first part, and after that, this will be updated continuously whenever the file is uploaded. So let's refresh. And select, well, first I have to delete this one, because if this one, it will be uploaded. Updated, since I have no images saved in the database, so just at the first time just select a image. So suppose this is the file. There is error. Not file is found. Well, we forget to add this one. Use file means we use it here. This and then use db for this one. So save. And just refresh. Well, just select this file. Success. Let's see the. Yes. The image also saved. Let's see if it is storing the database. Refresh. Well, there is the file name. If I upload chance, well, the file is uploaded. Let's see. The image is chance. And actually, this will be uploaded. updated after the insert. So, well, this part is already done, upload and save. But if I refresh this one, the uploaded file is now showing because I didn't trick the file from the database and when I enter this page. So let's go to the URL.
I add this line for getting the data from the table, database table, where is our table name in underscore history. So this line actually getting all the data from database, putting this into a variable where use db. That's why I use here use db. Make sure you have also this line. And then along with the view, I send the data, use this compate, and this in data, here this in data. Well, then in the view, instead of this single line, I use here these two line, these lines. Like if there is the variable that I sent via the controller, here in data, since we've get the one row only, so that's why here zero index. Well, and this is the column name, this column name. So if the there is no image empty function, if the data is empty, then we'll show the general picture. Else, that means we have image, then we'll show the image here. Refresh the view. Oh, we're getting the well. Hope it will be helpful for you. And of course, I will be back with a new lesson for you. So thank you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And do click on the bell icon so that you are regularly updated. Bye.